I'm Katherine Swanson, ICMSF member since 2001 and food safety consultant. In this presentation, I will discuss the use of microbiological testing for verification of food processing control. Quantitative tests for indicators or presence-absence testing for pathogens could be used. Which do you think is more useful to manage an effective food safety management program? Let's take a look at an example. When a manufacturer makes a food product, they know the specific processing conditions used. Proper validation of the food process provides greater assurance of food safety. Verification testing under processing conditions can provide information over time to demonstrate that the validated process is implemented as intended. In this hypothetical example, common ingredients are used for three different processes. Process 1 makes product for packaging line A, while the products from processes 2 and 3 are packaged on line B. The company conducts verification testing on each of these two packaging lines to monitor trends between lots and demonstrate that the processes are performing as expected. Remember that the same ingredients are used on all lines. What action do you take when an unacceptable result is found on line B? This chart illustrates hypothetical data for packaging line B using presence-absence testing for a pathogen. Keep in mind the product continues before the results are the production continues before the results are known because testing takes time. A pathogen is detected in lot number 8. As other ICMSF videos illustrate, it is difficult to know whether lots with a negative result may have low-level contamination that was not detected because of the sensitivity of microbiological testing. Thus, a positive result for a pathogen calls into question the safety of the lots produced before and after this positive lot. This chart also indicates or illustrates hypothetical data for packaging line B. However, a quantitative indicator is used. Many times, quantitative testing provides more actionable information for verification purposes. In this example, the line indicates a hypothetical maximum acceptable level for the indicator. When the data indicate that lot 8 exceed the acceptable levels, other lots are well within the acceptable range. This example provides assurance that conditions present support safe production of food, while the company takes action to determine the root cause of the unacceptable result for lot 8. This is an example of the usefulness of microbial testing for between lot verification. While quantitative microbiological testing does not provide real-time results for immediate action, it can be very useful when trend analysis is conducted. This requires examination of the data between lots. This example illustrates an increasing trend. It may indicate growth of bacteria in the processing line and perhaps the need for sanitation of the lines. This chart illustrates the benefit of charting the information in a timely manner to avoid exceeding limits. A company may have initiated investigation earlier to determine the cause of the fairly constant increase before unacceptable levels were observed. Some processes have significant variability, as illustrated in this chart. For example, variation can be observed in raw produce when weather patterns change. Seasonal variation can also be observed. A minimum of 30 lots of production is recommended to establish a baseline, but more data can be necessary to account for seasonality. This example illustrates a substantial difference in performance, which should be investigated. Is it due to seasonal variation? Was there a new ingredient used? Are new employees working? Is the process malfunctioning? Are pathogens detected through other testing? Using both quantitative indicators and presence-absence pathogen testing can be useful to evaluate situations such as this. Statistical process control can be a very useful tool in evaluating verification data for process control. When using microbial count data, the lower confidence limit, CL, typically is not considered to play a role, but automated statistical process programs will provide the information anyway. The upper control limit indicates a loss of control. Notice that the loss of control occurred around week 50 and 51, which would require investigation and likely corrective action. A proper verification activity would have included review of the data to observe for trends. For example, an increasing trend began in week 42 and continued with a few reductions up to loss of control at week 50. It is strongly encouraged that verification data for process control be evaluated for trends to enable corrections before loss of control. In conclusion, routine microbiological testing for verification can be highly beneficial when analyzed between lots for trends. Routine microbiological verification testing can provide assurance that conditions enable food, safe food production, the basis for analyzing performance trends so that corrective action can be taken before loss of control, insights into the cause of loss of control, and a warning that conditions changed, which may indicate the need to review and potentially revise the plan. ICMSF's Book 8 provides microbiological testing recommendations for 19 food product types. Please visit the ICMSF website for the latest information on ICMSF books and publications.